Hey there, welcome to another episode of Coding with CodeCat. This is Ravi, and in today's session, we are going to understand the sum keyword, which is also known as the opaque type. So in order to understand the sum keyword, let us begin with an example. Let us assume ki hamari ek manufacturing company hai aur ye jo company hai wo do products banati hai. One is a laptop and the other is a keyboard. And if I want to present this in a code, this is how it is going to look like. So I will have a protocol and let us name this protocol as product. And this is going to have a function named a description. And this description is going to say like what product description ka. If it is a laptop, we'll say this is a laptop, and if it is a keyboard, we'll say this is a keyboard. So I have a structure named laptop, which is going to inherit from the protocol product. And as I said, this is a laptop. And similarly, we have another structure. I'll copy this out, and I would say this is the structure keyboard, and this is keyboard. Every product has a product code. Now sometimes you must have observed ki kuch products ke jo product code hote hain wo string mein hote hain, aur kabhi kabhi kuch products ke product code jo hote hain wo pure integer mein hote hain. So what we are going to do in this case is jo laptop hai uska product code hum log string mein rakhenge, aur jo keyboard hai uska product code hum log integer mein rakhenge. And since both laptop and keyboard are inheriting from product, it makes more sense to declare the product code property inside the protocol. Lekin ab yahan pe ek unique requirement hai. The requirement is ki jo bhi property hogi yahan pe, it is going to be unique. Yani ke laptop ke case mein wo string hoga, aur jo keyboard ka case hai uske case mein wo integer hoga. So in this case, what we are going to do is we are going to use associated type. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to say code, and I'm going to declare the property product code of the type code, and then I would say get. And now when I implement this, I would say laptop ke case mein hum log ne kya decide kiya tha ki jo code hoga that will be of the type string, and I would say var product code is of the type string. Or jo keyboard hai uske case mein jo code hoga it is going to be of the type integer, and I would say product code is of the type integer. So far so good. And I think this is the first time that I'm explaining associated type in my channel, and right now you know what is the use case of using the associated type in your project. So right now we have everything. The only thing that is pending is manufacturing. So what we are going to do is we are going to say ki hamare paas ek factory hai jahan pe ye dono products banne wale hain. So I will have a function, I would say make products, and this is going to return me product. Now over here, Swift compiler is complaining. Let us see what it has to say. Protocol product can only be used as a generic constraint because it has self or associated type requirement. Abhi mujhe self ka to pata nahi, lekin associated type is something which we have used. As you can see over here, we have used associated type because hamari requirement ye thi ki jo laptop ke case mein jo product code hai mujhe string chahiye tha, aur jo keyboard ke case mein jo product code hai wo mujhe integer chahiye tha. And that is the reason why we have used associated type. Compiler is expecting us to return a concrete type. Now the problem is because of this associated type aapko ye error aa raha hai yahan pe. Agar aap ye associated type hata do to us case mein aapko ye error nahi aayega, because the error clearly mentioned ki it has self or associated type requirement. And this is the reason why Swift compiler is getting confused ki aap kya return karoge. Jo product hai yahan pe, product ke do alag alag implementation hai because of the associated type, and that is the reason why Swift compiler is not liking it. So in order to explain the Swift compiler ki hum log sirf ek hi concrete type return karne wale, you have to use the sum keyword. And right now what you can do is you can return, you would say laptop, and the product code can be, let's say, test. Now the Swift compiler is not giving us any error because use pata hai ki yahan pe aap ek concrete type return kar rahe ho. Now let us say this was just for demo purpose to make you explain like how does the sum keyword work with a protocol. Now let us say if this was a real project, main is tarika code nahi likhta. What I would have done is, I think you already know, is I would have directly returned laptop, and in the case of keyboard I would have directly returned keyboard over here. I would have done something like this. The reason is this is much simpler, but this is not the actual use of the sum keyword. The actual use of the sum keyword is encapsulation, that is hiding your concrete type from the real world. So in order to explain that, let me show you an example. So let us say mere paas ek function hai, and let me call this function as square array elements. And this is going to accept a generic parameter, which is going to be T of numeric. And I would say array. And this is array of the type T. So far, so good. Ab, ye jo function hai, ye kya return karega? Let me type it first. So this is going to return you a lazy map sequence. And this is going to be array of T, comma T. Aur iska jo implementation hai, it is actually very simple. This is going to be array dot, I would say not map, I would say lazy, oops, lazy dot map, and I would say, where is the dollar sign? I would say dollar zero multiplied by dollar zero. Okay, so in this case, the concrete type is lazy map sequence. Now let me show you the summary of this. This is a structure which is inheriting from the sequence protocol. Or agar koi bhi yahan pe type hai jo ek protocol se inherit kar raha hai, in this case it is sequence, then what you can do is, rather than returning something like this, you can return something which is more elegant. That is, I would say this is some sequence. To yahan pe maine protocol add kar diya hai, because this lazy map sequence was inheriting from a particular protocol, and in this case it was sequence. So, isliye maine yahan pe kya kiya? So in this case you can see ki how the sum keyword is helpful. Sum keyword ne yahan pe kya kiya ki jo lazy map sequence tha use hum return nahi karke. What we have did is we have just returned a sequence. I think that the sum keyword is more suited in situations like this, jahan pe, let's say, agar aap koi utility ya fir koi framework pe kaam kar rahe ho, to us case mein what you want to do is, you don't want to return the concrete type. Rather than that, what you want to do is you want to return the protocol. And for only that reason, I would be using the sum keyword. In live projects, I don't think so ki sum keyword ka zyada use hai. Because as you can see ki yahan pe jo hume problem aayi thi, we have handled the situations like this. Now there is one more place jahan pe object type ka sabse zyada use hota hai, and that is Swift UI. So let me switch to a Swift UI project. To yahan pe aap dekh sakte ho, at line number 12 you have a variable called as body, which is of the type sum view. And at line number 18 you have a static variable which is previous of the type sum view. Aur abhi humne seekha hai ki ye jo sum keyword hai, it should be used with protocols. So let us see what this view is. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to jump to definition, and over here you can see this is a public protocol. Aur iska jo code hai wo kafi had tak similar hona chahiye with the demo that we did today. So let me switch back to our example. Now let us say, agar aapne sum keyword use kiya hai aapke project mein, to I am really excited to know ki aisa kaunsa technical reason tha jiski wajah se aapne sum keyword ka use kiya, and how it has helped you. So do mention that as a comment, ya fir aap mujhe email kar sakte ho. My email id is codecat15@gmail.com. So I hope ye video dekhne ke baad aapko clear ho gaya hoga ki opaque types ko kab aur kaise use karna chahiye. Aaj ke session mein jo bhi humne code kiya hai wo already GitHub aur Google Drive pe updated hai, aur unki link maine video ke description mein mention ki hui hai. So if you need the code, what you can do is you can check the video description, click on the link and download the code for you. Now one request is, if you're learning something from my videos and if they are helping you in improving your code, then please do support the channel by subscribing it and sharing it with your iOS friends. Now that being said, thank you so much for watching this. Have a nice day and happy iCoding. Bye-bye.